So when it comes to choosing materials and textures and pens, our idea was to use a neutral palette for floors and walls. So most of the walls are white, and to break that monotony of white, we used this concrete kind of texture in living room, where there is a huge mass which runs from ground to a second floor. It's a slightly grayish, greenish gray kind of a texture which we really worked on, making it such a way that it complements our Italian flooring as well. This is a typical urban assignment where the plot is about 5,000 square feet and clients' requirements are much more than it could house. Because these days, in urban cities like Satara, space is limited. So normally when it's a home, we prefer to have just G+1, ground plus one structure as a dark, small, cozy house. But here we have gone for G+2 structures plus basement.
The context of this particular site is such that it faces the busy road, and also it is in the middle of the residential area. And looking at the buildings around, we knew that the planning had to be introvert. We had to create our own views and own garden because there's nothing to look outside at. The climate is one major part which plays a role. The north side, we have taken the major advantage from, where we get the least radiations and maximum diffused light. So the bungalow has a garden, piece of a garden on the northern side. And we have used large glazing areas where the living room and all the bedrooms open out to this garden. In terms of the climate or in terms of the privacy also, we have used wooden louvers which again give us privacy. Also they protect us from the radiation, and they have become the major element of the architecture of this particular bungalow. The materials which were chosen for this architecture are to do with the climate and the context. So we chose this natural material, tandoor stone, and we have used the vertical strips of tandoor which are cladded from outside, and in combination with wooden louvers. So it creates a very contemporary yet very rustic feel. And the verticality of the stone and the louvers, that's how we call it House of Lines.
We strongly believe that the spaces have to be in harmony with the nature, and that's our design philosophy. So when you enter this living room, to the right side you see there's a huge garden, and we design large walkouts to have that landscape and architecture space, the kind of interaction, and they complement each other. At the same time, we believe that in a house the spaces should interact at all levels. So we have designed a small courtyard which has a vertical garden as a focal point, which runs throughout the height of the courtyard, and which the courtyard also helps to have interaction of the spaces at the ground, first and second level. The double-headed living space helps to have interaction of the living room with the family on first floor.
The private spaces of the bungalow that are the master bedrooms of the house, they are located on the southwest part for two reasons. One is they are away from the road, so they go away from the noise. Secondly, they get the southwest breeze also. They open out to the northern garden, they get a view of the garden. Each bedroom has a theme which is, they differ in terms of the highlights of the theme, but a basic neutral palette has been used, which is wooden flooring and very neutral layout with a veneers and greys and whites. And the colors in each bedroom have been added through either the artwork or the upholstery and the cushions and the rugs. If we think about the son's bedroom, which is located on the first floor, there is a huge painting through which even the walk-in door happens through the painting. And to complement that painting, we have used this grey concrete look-alike texture which runs from a wall to the ceiling. So it creates a very neutral base for that vibrant painting. The room theme is suitable for the son, for his age, very vibrant, very young. For the daughter's bed, the theme is again, the base is white and grey, and a lot of textures have been used in that room. The one wall is done up with a metal artwork which is designed like a world map where she can put the pictures of the travel and taking from their hobbies, learning from their backgrounds. Each theme becomes very personalized for the room. And the pink sofa, which, you know, it just adds up a little tinge of enthusiastic thing in that room. So another space where we used texture is a puja room, where it's a triple heighted space where one of the walls has this textures which runs from ground to the second floor, and we have the texture is being highlighted with the wall art also. So these white leaves are placed on this texture which complement the texture, and the skylight which is at the top of the puja, the natural light pouring through it, just adds to the beauty.